An interesting thing is if one look at the physical body in a different way. Have a look what happens when the egg and the sperm meets and the cell division starts. The cell division follows a system. This system is its DNA design. According to its DNA design, the system will produce a specific form, whether it is human or animal, or any of the parts that make use of such a form of reproduction. Now, what is interesting, obviously, within this is to consider what does this imply, because you have a human physical body that, in essence, have formed a system where cell division is coming from the same original set of DNA. That means it's one system, but that the system design is such that the cells will divide into various groups that will support the one system, which is the final form in its complete functionality. Therefore, you'll have cells that look different and that do different functions, but they are part of the original DNA. Cell division, it is the same source. What is now fascinating is that with all these cells together in one body, they develop the functional force that manages it as a unity. That force that develops is called consciousness. That consciousness is now, in essence, the voice that speaks on behalf of all these cells. And if you can imagine that each one of these cells is a living being in itself with identity, form and functionality, just like a human. Within the human body, therefore, in essence, you can take a human body as a world with multiple cultures, multiple purposes, multiple functions, jobs, all working together to have one world system operating. The same happens in the human body, and this is now managed by consciousness. The question, though, that one must ask yourself is that if you look at the human physical being in terms of the cells and how they interact, and the consciousness is whether the consciousness is serving the human physical body, or is the consciousness acting as if it is more like a god that has power over the physical body and all his subjects, which is all the cells, and that it doesn't care about what happens in the physical body, which was, after all, the source from which this so-called consciousness was born. This is very similar to what happens in the world. The world system has become a form of consciousness that do not care about the human that is participating in the system. And it is acting from a perspective as if it is more, as if it knows more. But it has no concern whatsoever for the individual experience of each human in the world. Exactly like the human has no concern, or the consciousness of the human has no concern of what actually happens in the physical human body. And what's fascinating is then when the disease comes, it's similar to having a revolution on Earth. You have a revolution in the body and you have cancer, for instance, developing. What is that? That's a mutation. Okay, so what is happening is the cells has decided they are no longer going to serve under this God called consciousness, the personal identity, that thing that has become God, that no longer cares about them, and they go into a state of revolution. A disease then obviously happens within the physical body over which consciousness has got no power. It can only restore that by restoring the relationship between itself and the physical. So if one go in to do forgiveness, for instance, and restore the relationship between the consciousness and the physical body, and you restore harmony between the two, there is the possibility that the physical might stop its revolution and says, okay, I'll give you another chance. But inevitably, what happens is that the consciousness destroys its world, its body, and in the end, the body dies and nothing of the consciousness remains. Because when you go to the afterlife, you'll see that nothing remains. Because the consciousness was the result of all the physical parts, the cells, that participated as one within the form it was manifesting as within its DNA system design. Every human being is simply a reflection or representation of Earth, with its consciousness being a representation of the world system. And have a look, nobody cares, just like the human being don't care. Do you see that?